Dimethylmercury. It is a word that is enough to scare most scientists. In ways, this chemical is even dangerous than cyanide. Its most scary property came to light when it victimized a great scientist called Karen wetterHahn. Karen wetterHahn was a professor of chemistry at Dartmouth College in 1996. She specialized in toxic metal exposure. On 14th August 1996, she was studying the effects of mercury on DNA. Dimethylmercury at that time was used as a reference standard for mercury measurements. It is formed by treating sodium amalgam with methyl halides. It was one of the earliest organometallics, that is, compounds that contain at least one carbon atom and a metal, and due to its stability, it was widely used. It should be noted that she was an expert in the field and was well aware how to handle toxic compounds. During the experiment, one or two drops of dimethylmercury spilled on her glove. At that time, she believed that it was safe as she was taking all the precautions, so she later proceeded to clean it up. It was not known at that time that dimethylmercury can pass through latex gloves in just 15 seconds and later enter the skin. 17 days later, she discovered that her hair testing revealed very high levels of mercury, which kept increasing until 39th day and then reduced. But here is what makes it really scary. Dimethylmercury is a very strong neurotoxin and slowly starts to work while the victim is in utter state of helplessness. 3 months later, she experienced abdominal discomfort and weight loss, still battling with the agony. In January 1997, neurological symptoms like loss of balance and slurred speech appeared. She was given very strong chelation therapy, which involves administering agents to remove heavy metals from the body. This process is mostly used when everything else fails, because it has its own risks. 3 weeks later, despite all efforts, she went into a vegetative state with periods of extreme agitation. On June 8, 1997, she passed away in less than a year after the accident because just one or two drops of dimethylmercury spilled on her glove. There have been other cases like this. In 1865, two English lab assistants were killed while synthesizing this compound for the first time. In 1992, a 28-year-old chemist in Czechoslovakia died in similar manner while synthesizing this chemical. After her death, the required safety measures were changed. Several experiments were performed and better safety equipment were made mandatory. It should be noted that she was using all the safety measures, including a fume hood. Later on, the use of dimethylmercury was significantly reduced and was replaced by less toxic substitutes. World of Science is filled with the people who selflessly worked for the greater good of the society. And the world will always be in their debt. Hit the subscribe button for more videos, and as always, keep learning, keep exploring until you know everything.